encyclopedia of vernacular. Encyclopedia of Vernacular of the World by Paul Oliver, which I gather is a 10-year collection of vernacular articles with quite a large array of contributors from around the world, and some really remarkable reviews by Cambridge and Reba. It's no longer in print, which is a bit of a worry. I kind of wonder why it's no longer in print, because it is fantastic. However, it itself professes that there is far more work to be done, and I, by no means have I read all of it. This is not a review of all of it. I think I've done Anthropomorphic and Cognitive, the preface and the introduction, and these, and am yet to do quite a bit of other, and I've looked into Australian, more like white culture Australian rather than Indigenous, which is really surprising, because it helped formulate the idea that it's very good if you're going to look into vernacular architecture, because it stipulates that vernacular is actually very hard to define. It covers a very broad range of time frames, materials, cosmogony, all sorts of things, and indeed takes a large portion to try to give to the user this idea of what possibly could fall into vernacular. So by having a look at it, one then realizes that discussing vernacular is essentially the discussion of vernacular is the discussion of any kind of architecture. So by stating that, I kind of undermines concepts of neo-vernacular. It even undermines concepts of its where vernacular originated from, and it puts to the question even concepts of traditional architecture, which it says is a simile of vernacular and not really a subcategory of vernacular. So if you're ever going to see where someone suggests vernacular and then goes into traditional, Paul Oliver would probably have it that they're talking about the same thing. And this means that as individuals who are writing on vernacular, we need to identify precisely what we are going to talk about, or what within the scope of common building we actually want to define. And thus we get to, if this allows us to define vernacular how we choose to define vernacular, but it also, in allowing us to do that, it has certain guidelines. If we look into specifically Melbourne or Victorian vernacular or Australian vernacular, all it does is outline the origin of cavity wall construction and multi-residential timber frame construction. It suggests that this was done within Australia without much exterior influence, and whilst there's certain relationships with American balloon frames, the construction technique is different, and it seems to have developed upon its own merits, and that it broadly resembles Australia's colonial heritage. However, there's probably a lot more scope to look at where some of the alteration in the exterior design. So I'm thinking of City of Port Phillip, etc., which really show lots of, you know, laurel motifs and heads of Athena, etc., etc. This means, though, that vernacular cannot be defined by some kind of look into regional architectures from points in history, and it must be identified with gross construction techniques. By gross, I mean the average construction techniques. So vernacular isn't, and this is, so, sorry, this is where neo-vernacular undoes itself. The Welsh cottage is vernacular because it is evident in the bulk of building regimes at that time. MRTFC is a vernacular because the bulk standard kind of living, kind of house for living is MRTFC in Victoria. The yurt is a vernacular because the bulk of Mongolians who live in a yurt and Siberians live in that form of structure. And this means that in a contemporary ideal, that by this stipulation, one can only suggest that the bulk of living construction, so say that's high-rise construction in inner city Melbourne, is, you know, 25 square metre to sort of 40 square metre apartment studios, open plan, what have you, or similar, and that is the vernacular. That's the neo-vernacular, or it's the current vernacular. I know that neo-vernacular tries to look at cottage industries as informative, or craft industries as informative of materiality, and suggest that this is vernacular, but it's not. That's utilization of contemporary craft industries. And by no means does the term vernacular substantiate one-off designs, irrelevant of how they interact with a vernacular. So if you were in Wales, a neo-vernacular